Hello and welcome to 27 Fox Place. In today's video, I'm going to be deep cleaning my master bedroom, and I would like to invite you to join me while I clean the entire room from top to bottom. I need to strip the bed linens today, but before I do that, I need to dust the ceiling fan. That way the mattress is protected from any dust that may fall down from the fan, and then I can toss the bedding into the washing machine. When the weather is warmer, which is most of the year, the ceiling fan runs 24/7, and because it's always running, it's something I tend to overlook during my regular dusting routine. So when the dust accumulates to this extent, it's time to get out the ladder and wipe down the fan blades. I've learned it's much easier to remove excess dust before I use any cleaning products, otherwise all that dust just turns into a muddy mess. I'm using Methods Wood for Good to wipe down the fan blades because it's safe for sealed wood surfaces, and it doesn't leave behind a residue for dust to stick to. One of my favorite cleaning tools is a clean paintbrush. The soft bristles won't scratch or damage any delicate surfaces, but they're still stiff enough to clean out hard to reach nooks and crannies. And when I'm done, all I have to do is rinse it out in the sink. Part of my deep cleaning routine includes washing the bed linens, and I typically wash the duvets and quilts about every month or two. And because I don't want to take the extra time to fold all the linens, I'm just going to wash them and put them back on the bed. I need to start the wash so that by the time I'm finished cleaning the rest of the room, I can remake the bed. The laundry detergent I'm using is Kirkland's brand, and I like that it's unscented so I can pair it with Downy scent beads. I like using the scent beads because I can control how much or how little fragrance I add to the laundry. It's also a good idea to zip up your zippers so that they don't snag on other items during the wash. I also use vinegar as a fabric softener because it's economical and it works without chemicals. But also, we have hard water and it helps to keep the deposits from building up inside the washer. Thank you. Our walls are heavily textured, so this is a good time to run a duster over the walls and remove any cobwebs and dust that may collect over time. So as I make my way around the room, I'll move from the ceiling to the floor, making sure to get behind the furniture as much as I can. Once I finish dusting the walls, I can move on to the furniture, and I'll just wipe everything down with some multi-purpose cleaner as I clear the surface. I like to use methods wood for good on sealed wood surfaces, and because this wood is unsealed, I'm using lemon oil. It's something I like to do once or twice a year to protect the wood and keep it from drying out. This candelabra is something that I absolutely love, but I've been having a difficult time trying to find the right place for it. So I'm going to put it up here for now and see if I like it. I've had this artificial tree for years, and I found the easiest way to clean it is just to spray the leaves with the hose and to let it air dry. I like to avoid using chemicals on the mirrors, so I'm just going to use a damp microfiber cloth to clean the surface, and then I'll use another microfiber to buff it dry. use to oil the furniture gets so saturated with lemon oil that it's not practical to wash it, and I don't want to throw out a rag every time I oil the furniture. So instead, I just keep a rag for this purpose and I use this case to store it. This deep clean is long overdue, and as you can see, there's a lot of lint and dust that's built up on these lampshades. I try to avoid using products like vacuums and dusters that come in contact with the fabric. Instead, I like to take them outside and use a leaf blower to dust them off. I'm going to vacuum along the edge of the baseboard using a crevice attachment, and then I'll wipe down the baseboards and the lower part of the walls with a damp microfiber cloth. I'm not going to clean the bed today. Once a year, I like to pull all the furniture away from the walls so I can vacuum underneath, so I include the bed with this spring cleaning routine. If you're wondering why I didn't wash the Euroshams today, it's because they were being used in the guest room until just recently, and I washed them when I decided to use them in here instead. The quilt I washed today is still in the dryer, and because it was getting late in the day and I got busy with dinner and other things, I wasn't able to get it back on the bed until much later in the evening. So this is the next day, and this is how the room turned out. That's all for now, and thank you so much for joining me today. If you enjoyed this video, be sure and give it a thumbs up, and make sure to subscribe so that you can receive notifications when I post new videos. There's absolutely no obligation for subscribers, and it's easy to do. Just click the subscribe button down below and hit the bell icon to turn on notifications. So I'll say goodbye for now, and I hope to see you in the next video.